This part, if you can do this stealth, then congratulations. Because this one's kind of hard to do. This guy will always spot the door opening. So you have to kill him right there, ASAP. Doing one of those melee kills will not cut it. And if you have a sniper rifle and a bunch of ammo, please use it. It'd be very useful to do it. And, well, even I could do this. Let's put it that way. I mean, this is not hard at all, sniping. You're sniping still targets. Anybody can do that. It's when they're moving that's a big issue. See? Even I'm not that bad. I'm a competent sniper now. I shoot still targets. I'm probably a better sniper in real life than I am at video games, ironically. That's true, I went to a biathlon range over the summer. You know, biathlon's a Winter Olympics event, but they always have the training facility up. So I went there. And the targets they shoot at are about the size of a dime. Not kidding. About the size of a dime. And they gave you a 22 rifle and about 10 shots to shoot 10 targets that are about double the size, slightly, of the regulation Olympic targets. And 5 out of 10. It's a lot harder than you think, too, because the thing has a sight, but the sight has, like, a circle.
Have you found your precious helicopter yet, Bond?
The thing has a circle in the middle of it. Well, speaking of sniping, try to snipe these two guys as fast as possible. As you can see, I actually succeed for once. Even though I don't know how. But, you have the scope, though the scope actually zooms out. You have like a tiny circle in the center that you can use to aim, but when you look at the target through that scope, it looks like a tiny speck. There's no crosshairs or anything like that. It's just a tiny little speck in this small little circle. Where if you're, like, slightly off, you're gonna miss. It requires a real steady hand and a lot- and some pretty good luck. It's tough. It's tough. You think a scope would make it easier? Ironically, it really doesn't. It's only there, just seems like... just because. It makes it- I guess it makes it slightly easier, but than without a scope. But honestly, it's ridiculous. But shooting 5 out of 10 when you never shot a gun before in your life, I guess it says something about you.
When you finish with your holiday snaps, Bond, meet me at the rendezvous. We're running out of time.
When you're done with this, get ready because there's gonna be a firefight. I've tried using the Pavlov in the past, and the only thing it does is I get overrun and people come up right behind me. So this is probably the best way to do it. Just watch him walk right up the staircase and kill him. Line him up, knock him down. You should be dead by now, buddy. You don't have armor on, as far as I know. A trench coat does not provide 10 bullets worth of armor. And I always prefer trying to shoot out the guard in the sniper tower. It's kind of a hard shot, but useful nonetheless. You can see, you have to be pretty particular with your shot. Winter on the road, get ready for another firefight. There'll be two waves of enemies coming. First, just pretty much already stationed. The second will soon be stationed. But you'll see them, they'll be running in. You can just mow down three of them probably on the first try. If you have a fully automatic like I do. Whenever I played my friends in Call of Duty, I never used like any snipers or anything like that because I always sucked. So I always had an AR with me. Typically like an M4A1 or whatever. Anything that shoots, you know, fully automatic. usually with a sight. And then to top that off, I would use a machine pistol. So I could actually go for really long kill streaks just by using pretty much the same guns, pretty much. If I ever ran out of AR ammo, the machine pistol always got the job done about the same. And I've had times where I actually used the machine pistol more than the AR. I would get like 6 kills straight with it. But all in all, I'm like a, you know, just like a mediocre COD player, just your average one. I'll have games where I'm pretty much on fire and get like 7 kill streak, and you know, I'll go like 21 kills versus 14 deaths. Now of games where I go 13 kills as opposed to 21 deaths. So yeah.
James, I've created a little diversion to cover our exit.
As you can see, another phone opportunity means go in here. This one's tough to spy if you're not look if you don't know where to look. I really did not know where to look. It took me 20 minutes to find that originally. And yeah. Next, they are approaching, so make sure you use your sniper rifle. I wish I had something epic I could say here, but the only thing I could say is respond to this. Bam. These guys really aren't that hard. I mean, when you have a silent sniper rifle, that's a Pavlov that's standing in front of me, by the way, but it's unsilenced, so they know who's shooting it. So you have a silenced one, and more power to you. You can really do damage. You also have to be careful though, because you just stay sniping like that too long, there's going to be someone that's going to run right up the steps and ambush you. Don't ask me how I know that. It's happened to me already. More often than I would like to admit. Twice instead of one time. Thankfully, I killed enough of them in the first wave, so that all that was left was two people charging in. So it's kind of easy pickings. It's weird for me because I'm still trying to get used to the Wii controls. Every time I play a shooting game, I never use the Wii. I always use, except for Metroid Prime. If you really want to call that an FPS, because I'm not sure if I would. It's more of a adventure-related game. So the FPS elements aren't exactly designed for the most hardcore player.
James, have you reached the rendezvous yet?
I always played on Xbox. And the phone thing goes off again, which means you know where to look at. It looks like you got a door in front of you that you gotta go through. Okay. Don't use a, don't use the Sigmas here, or an AK. You should be able to kill this guy stealth. You can actually kill the guys in this room stealth, but it's pretty tough to do. I've never been able to do it, but I dealt with the bullshit of shooting a guy in the top of the head with a sniper rifle, and the guy survived. And not only that, was not fazed by it. How do we know it hit him? Oh, because the crosshair was right across his head. The center of his head, and it missed.
Damn! You'd have thought that after the fall of communism, the Russians might have invested in some 21st century transportation by now.
As you can see, I fail right away. Tremendously, mind you. After, as soon as you miss, it's pretty much screw that, screw the rule book, screw the sniper rifle, shoot everything in sight because you're gonna have a lot of enemies to shoot at. So 6 or 7, I'm gonna say. Probably more. Depending on how many you snipe, of course. They come from everywhere, so. If you can, try to get yourself over to this area. It'll help you because you'll be able to use the sides to strafe around enemies. And they won't be too aware of your presence, hopefully. And that guy should be dead. But apparently, he's not. And that guy dies, even though, clearly, it wasn't my best aiming job. I'll try to fix the post-commentary. Obviously, because I really don't like doing post-commentary. It sucks. Reason it sucks? The reason it sucks, it just feels like you're detached. I prefer that not being the case. I do my best work when I'm live, even though I blather and, you know, kind of like spit out the wrong words 80% of the time. And you get to see me get hopelessly lost for about 5 minutes. So, with the use of some editing, right here, we'll cut back to the area where I actually find out what the hell I'm doing. And we're back. It got so bad I actually had to resort to a walkthrough just to see what the hell I was supposed to do. I hate doing that. But I'm gonna be honest here. How the hell can you spot that little thing? You have to shoot that lock. How the hell is anybody gonna notice that first try? I sure didn't. That's a tiny little speck that's not even standing out. There's nothing indicating that you need to shoot that. I'm sorry. Except for the obvious fact it's a lock, but you know what? How am I gonna see that? That thing is tiny. I sit 5 feet away from the screen, I couldn't see it. Which is pathetic. So yeah, AVGN type rave aside, this is the last mission you really need to do. And then it's just basically sprinting to the end, nothing special. You don't have to worry about enemies like I originally thought I did, because it'll automatically take you over here.
Get your hands in the air!
And Bond got caught. Great.
Take off your parachute. Hand it over!
If you insist.
Yep.
See reflections on the water, more than darkness in the depths. See him surface and never a shadow. On the winds I feel his breath. Goldeneye found his weakness. Goldeneye, no time for sweetness, but a bitter kiss will bring him to his knees. You'll never know what you from
Nice trick. Doing it without a parachute. Trying to show me up?
You said we were running late. Let's move.
Hey, James. For England?
For England, Alec. Always for England.
I'm not going to let my extensive acting history influence my opinion of Daniel Craig in this game. Even though it's no secret, I'm not a big fan of Daniel Craig as Bond. 27 minutes. Get used to that, because I play very, very conservatively when I do an FPS. I always have, I always will. I'll see what I can do to speed up time and whatnot, but don't expect it. So next time around, I'll see you guys.